Bristol Community College Bayhawks versus Springfield Technical Community College.
All right, well, you wanted announcers, you got them. You got the C connection. You got the C team, you got Cardoza, Craig the Cowboy, and Cabral. As you join us in action, as a three-pointer. That's gonna be Jose Mercado for three. All right, I wanna welcome everybody to NJCAA Basketball Action Division III, Junior College Basketball. It's the Bristol Community College Bayhawks and the Springfield Technical Community College Rams. The Rams are in their maroon with the white trim, with the white stripes. The BCC bench is hype. And Bristol Community College is the home team in white with the green trimming. So again, I want to welcome in the Portuguese Cowboy, the Portuguese Terror after 8 p.m., Mr. Craig Salvador. How you doing, Craig?
What is good? Doing pretty well. This game's so fast-paced. I'm glad I got my coffee now.
Yeah,
better stay awake for this one.
Better late than never, but Lucy Cabral was holding down the court. Lucy Cabral on doing the fancy camera work, as we call it. This game just underway. We didn't miss much, Craig, so.
Well, we did miss those. The Bayhawks' first points, getting the lead. Huh? Missed, of course, the lovely rendition of the national anthem by our very own Lucy.
The national anthem?
Ooh.
Oh, wow.
That was impressive by the Pope.
The Pope is back. Oh. Driving to his left was number 14. Paul Bissett missed it, but then with the putback, number 24, Arvin Gordon.
Oh.
And the other end is your boy, the Pope. This game a lot faster, a lot more faster pace than the women's game. So.
Yeah, I feel like I'm going to have to take a nap after this.
A lot more riled up, 9-2. Welcome on a Saturday afternoon.
Yep.
And just briefly on the court now for the Bristol Community College Bayhawks, number 4, Desmond Jernigan, number 14, Armani Baker, number 23, Marcus McCarthy, number 13, the Pope, Quincy Pope, and number 11, Jose Mercado, round out the starting five right now for the Bayhawks, who have a 9-2 early lead, stolen away by Jernigan. Jernigan driving the lane, puts it up, going to get fouled. Looks like he got fouled by number 5 there, Kevin Thompson, freshman forward.
Just went for everything there. Just ran into a wall.
Don't want to do that. We're at Bishop Connolly High School, home of the Bishop Connolly Cougars, also the home of the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. Bayhawks coached by eighth-year coach Rob Delalue. McCarthy gets it to the lane, puts it up, no good.
Quick hands by the Bayhawks with their passing game.
Bayhawks have a totally different look. They played on Tuesday, and it was a totally different team. Bayhawks actually got blown out on Tuesday against Bunker Hill. They lost 114-89, but they were without some of their key contributors, Jose Mercado, freshman four from Taunton, Mass. They were also without your boy there, Quincy Pope. And we're also missing Kevin Desire. Those guys are all back in uniform, so the BCC at full strength right now.
Definitely great to see those guys back.
Pope for the free throw line. Makes it. Like I said, BCC lost nine. They lost their last game. That puts them at 9-3. 9-3 overall and 9-3 in the region. Springfield Technical Community College comes into today's game 8-7, 6-5 in Region 21, holding their own. As I said, the head coach is Rob Delalue, the first Bristol head coach to reach 100 wins. He did that last year on December 10th of 2015. Driving to the hole, putting it up with his left, no good. Rebounded by the Bayhawks, that's McCarthy. McCarthy, nice stutter step, goes up. Can't make the shot, but he'll go to the free throw line.
I just want to take a minute to talk about how great of a rebound that was by Armani Baker. See him flying in there, grabbing it, getting the quick pass before he flies out of bounds. That was impressive.
Oh, that was a rebound by Baker. He did it so quick, it ended up in McCarthy's hands. That's why I thought McCarthy had the rebound, but.
No, it was Baker just flying in, getting the pass off quick. Like I said, very impressive.
That's what we always talk about, Armani Baker, and how he's kind of undersized for a big man or for a forward, but he does a lot of dirty work down there, gets a lot of rebounds.
Yeah, I remember before the break, he was Mr. Double-Double, averaging pretty much.
Yeah. You got that right, Craig, and as McCarthy sinks a second free throw, Armani Baker leads the team in scoring and rebounding with nearly 11 boards and over 17 points a game. BCC now the trap. Nice dump pass in. R.J. Veneziano.
So the bench is much louder on both sides.
Three-point shot. Mercado sinks it. Jose Mercado for three. Man, bun, and all.
That's where the power lies.
Get 15 that, to 4 early.
Get that trending. Hashtag man bun power.
Driving to his left. Nice take by Bissett. Missed it. BCC with the basketball. McCarthy directing traffic. Oh, nice in. Nice pass. Nice entry pass by McCarthy. Gets it to Jernigan. Springfield's going to take a timeout here. And BCC playing a lot better, fully manned, and they get an early lead, 17-4 here in the first half.
I tell you, you got to love it. Team's fired up. Everyone's fired up. Great to see all these guys back.
Yeah. Totally different team.
Yep, totally different team, but this team is the winning team. Already up 13 points, about five minutes of pass in the first half.
BCC playing with a lot more energy, a lot more aggressiveness, better defense too. And the offense looks like it has much more continuity in this one. And they get their scorers back. They lack scoring in the last game. Even though they ended up scoring 89 points, they lack that go-to guy. But
exactly.
It's good to see them bring a little bit more of that scoring punch back and deepen out that bench, lengthen that bench out.
We talked about it before. BCC has a great bench.
And they definitely do. driving to the hole. Not making the shot, but that's Isaiah Hidley, freshman forward. Last year, Springfield Technical Community College were the hosts of the Region 21 tournament, in which BCC finished as a runner-up to Bunker Hill. That was a fun tournament to be a part of. They have a DJ there. When you go to Springfield Technical Community College, they have a DJ that plays during the women and men's basketball games. Gets pretty hyped up.
It's pretty sick.
Both free throws made by Isaiah Hidley. Oh. That ball almost knocked out of bounds. Baker going baseline. And I think they're going to call... I'm not sure who the foul. That was an offensive foul away from the ball. It looks like it's going to be on Jernigan. Either way, it's a turnover, and the Rams have the basketball. That's Paul Bissett.
The shot clock's winding down. Gotta do something.
BCC and man-to-man. Shot clock winding down, four in the shot clock, going into the lane, puts it up, no good. Rebound is good. Lorenzo Akins gets the rebound. Pass by McCarthy, finds it deep to Pope, gets the lay-in and the foul. And he's amped up about it.
He's fired up. Tell you, Pope splashing some holy water on them.
The Pope taking over his sanctuary. Here in the holy castle of Bishop Conley High School.
Nothing says great basketball like Catholic high schools.
That's right. It's like an old cathedral. And Quincy Pope, he makes a three-point play. 20-8. Oh, wait, nice way to divide the defenders. 14 ball Bissett.
Yeah, great move going to his left.
Yeah, nice dribble crossover.
You know.
Get in through the defense. Bad pass there by, that's our new guy, that's Espinal. Not in our roster, but he was a starter during the last game. Jose Espinal, number three. McCarthy, cross court pass to Pope. Shot clock winding down. They'll get it down low. Mercado kicks it back out. McCarthy for three from the top. Makes it. Nice ball movement. Nice ball movement. Nice pass from Mercado. Back out to McCarthy. Drains a three. Drains it home. That ball tipped out of bounds. They're going to say it's off the Rams.
And when the Bayhawks were on offense down there, you could hear Springfield Tech, they were screaming for shooter. Now, the thing is, they got Bayhawks, they have so many shooters, you don't really know who they're talking about.
They have so many shooters and so many guys that can get their own shot and so many guys that can drive to the hole, a lot of athletic players, too. Springfield Technical College struggling to find their rhythm. Jernigan going to the hole, and they're going to call an offensive.
He took a hard bump on that.
Yeah, Jernigan went like a ball of fire, like a head of steam going right at Isaiah Hedley. And that foul is going to be on Jernigan. That's going to be his second. He's got two.
Four total for the Bayhawks this half.
Six for the Rams.
Yep.
Losing the basketball.
That's just no good.
It's going to be Pope up ahead to Mercado. Lays it in nicely on the break, 25-10.
Just a bad move by Springfield, just giving it to an open man.
They're going to call a foul, I believe, on Mercado away from the basketball.
Yeah. They call a technical? Yep.
I'm not sure what they call is. I know it's on Mercado.
Yeah, they're calling a technical on him.
Not sure if he said something or what, but.
I don't know. Might have been chirping.
And Headley misses the first free throw. Going to be two fouls early for Mercado. And Headley drains the second free throw. 25-11, 12:09 left to play here in the first half. The last time these two teams played each other was at Springfield. BCC came out a winner, 82-73. BCC with good defense, good trap.
Just surrounding him.
Wow, BCC all over the Rams. Miss. Rebound by 24, Arvin Gordon. Arvin Gordon with a couple hoops here in this first half.
Carthy directing traffic again.
Nine on the shot clock. Got to get a shot. Here's Pope to McCarthy. Try to dish it into Espinola. Knocked away. Driving. Jump stop. Can't get it to go. Victor Aichte with the miss. BCC basketball.
McCarthy looking for a pick.
Espinola losing it.
So just back-to-back bad turnovers.
I think Coach Del Lue might be going to his bench. I thought he was. Because Espinola, Rob Del Lue, Coach Del Lue. Talking to number three there, Espinola. Trying to get him going. All right, jumper. Jumper in the lane over Espinola is Arvin Gordon. Here's Pierre. Pierre in the corner.
Ooh.
Bad pass.
Bayhawks have just been having bad possessions these last three times.
Lopez, like a little mighty mite, going into the lane, gets fouled. That's Christopher Lopez. And they're going to call a foul there. I think it's on Pope. And yep. It is on Pope. That's going to be his second. Yep. BCC has a couple. They have a few players now that have two fouls, Craig.
Yeah. Now both teams already in the bonus. Some confusion now about the call on the court.
I think a little confusion as to what a personal foul. A technical foul is still a personal foul, but it's only one. It doesn't double dip in any way. So you're not getting two fouls on the same call. I think that's what Coach Del Lue was trying to straighten out or confirm. I think it only counts as one team foul. The technical.
Yeah. They're still having some confusion. They're trying to figure this out.
Either way, 25-16. BCC in control of this basketball game, but not so good possessions by them.
No, they need coming back after this. They're going to need a good possession because they've thrown the last three away, from just bad passing, really.
Yeah, and this whole timeout deal, this whole trying to get this right.
Yeah. And something we've seen from the Bayhawks this game is they love that long-range pass, but these last possessions, it hasn't been working for them.
Yeah, you live by that, you die by that. It's all or nothing. Inbound to the basketball is Christopher Lopez to Headley. Headley being trapped in the corner. They try to get inside to Arvin Gordon. And
it's another foul called.
They're going to call another foul.
That's Armani Baker.
And Baker has one. That's his first.
That was so anticlimactic. You were, expecting more.
I expected two. Because it was two. They had two up there. Now it's one.
Yeah.
And everybody else has
that's
two.
That's his first. Everyone else has two, yeah.
And I don't know what he was thinking. Gordon, prematurely, if you want to run away and not shoot the other one, that's fine, right?
I mean, yeah, I don't know.
What if he just declined, like, I don't want to shoot another one, I'm good.
Here, he'll just miss this one to appease it. Or not.
Springfield in the bonus. BCC going to call a timeout, 25-17. So this game looked like it was going to run away from the Rams, and they've kept in it. Careless turnovers by BCC. And some bad fouls, a lot of fouls here lately. So Springfield Technical Community College shooting themselves back into it via the free throw line.
Yeah, already the half's not even halfway done. Both teams already in the bonus.
Yeah.
Seven fouls for the Bayhawks, six for the Rams. So, but like
yeah,
we said,
so it's going to be a one-on-one situation going forward.
Yeah. But.
Well, only six of the Rams. I think it's seven for to get into the bonus. Ten for the double bonus.
Yeah.
So 10-21 left. So BCC 9-3. They're the second. They are tied for first in Region 21 with Bunker Hill. Those two are the top two teams in Region 21. So those two teams are fighting it out. And previous to the last game, Craig, BCC was on an 8-game win streak before they lost the last game against Bunker Hill, a team that they beat earlier in the season. At Bunker Hill, they defeated them 93-61 back on November 22nd. They lost to them this past Tuesday, but they didn't have the full squad. Today they have the full squad, so BCC looking to get back to status, per se.
Yeah, exactly. Like I was about to say, I think if we had the full squad last game against Bunker Hill, it would have been a very different game.
Very different. Look at the trap. Baker at the free throw line takes it in. Can't get his own rebound. It's going to stay here with five on the shot clock, so BCC needs to get off a shot quick as they'll rebound from the corner.
Just after the timeout, both teams like a bat out of hell.
McCarthy
fast.
Kicks it back out. Pierre at the clock buzzer. No good. Won't hit the rim. It's going to be a shot clock violation, and the Rams bench is liking it. Dan Menes will check in.
Seeing
and Kevin Desire.
Kevin Desire.
They come in for Pierre and Espinal, respectively. Danny Mendes in there as well. I'm not sure where he's been.
Well, I kind of like this matchup of Lopez and Mendes, though.
Hidley, turn around. Flips it up. No good. Gets his own rebound. No good. Gets his own rebound. Gets the contact, and this time, the third time is a charm.
Desire got his legs taken out from under him. You see him hit the ground hard.
Who's that?
Kevin Desire hit the ground hard. It looked like he got his legs taken out from under him, but the foul is going to be on him.
Get a rebound. Get a rebound in there. Three opportunities for Hidley, and the third time was costly because now he's going to the line for a chance for a three-point play, in which he gets. And now it's a five-point lead. Looks like a 1-2-2 defense by the Rams. Going baseline, going strong. That's his go-to move right there on the baseline, putting him up strong off the glass,
yep.
Armani Baker.
That was something the Bayhawks needed because we haven't seen him have a good possession in a while.
BCC with that aggressive man-to-man defense. Christopher kicking it back out, thinking about it. Ooh, lost his footing. Gordon lost his footing there. BCC with the basketball. Again, if you're just joining us, watching this on Channel 95 in your dial on FR Media, on your Comcast dial, 27-20. The Bristol Community College Bayhawks of Fall River up seven here. McCarthy sinks the front end of a 1-1. The foul was committed by number 2, Christopher Lopez, freshman guard. McCarthy calmly sinks both free throws.
Mercado checks in for McCarthy. MC
those
for
two,
MC.
Those two players, aren't they like, they seem like mirror images of each other. I think McCarthy with a little bit more better handle.
Yeah, Mercado's got a little more height. Fouls on Pope.
That's another Pope. Pope not liking that.
No.
He said that's crazy. Using that forearm, you got to be careful. These refs are going to call it, pushing off. That's only his first.
I could have sworn he had at least one other.
I thought so earlier, too. I thought he had two earlier, but just going to go by what the scoreboard. Free throw missed on the 1-1. Rebounded by Desire. Flips it up to Mendez. Mercado behind his back. Cross court. To Pope for three. Air ball.
Too much power behind that.
Here's Bissett in the open floor. To Lopez. A little bit undersized. BCC does a great job of switching. Oh, nice pass. Nice pass by Hindley. Gets it down to Gordon.
That was good movement. Looked like he wasn't going to have much with it. He brought it down, but he's able to put it back up. Good points by the Rams.
Mercado for three. No good. Rebounded by Bissett.
That took a bad bounce. No one was there to rebound it.
BCC's in for a basket. They're in for a game. They get it down low. Hindley with his left hand. No good. Lopez guarding Mendez. He's two guys almost the same height.
That's what I said.
Mendez actually has a height advantage over Lopez.
You don't get to say that too often.
Yeah. Oh, my goodness. Pope loses the basketball.
This is a bad miscue.
Oh, nice play. Little dipsy do. Nice flip there. Nice pass by
now that
by
was
Lopez
just a
to Victor Agti. Agti.
Going back to that turnover, that was just a bad miscue. It looked like it was trying to be a bounce pass maybe to Kevin Desire, but he just wasn't part of it and just got stolen away.
Yeah, he definitely took a risk there throwing into traffic, and he telegraphed that one. But Mendez going to the line. These two teams are going to be shooting free throws for the remainder of the first half with 7:10 left to go from Conley. Mendez sinks the first one. So Springfield isn't going to go away. They are in this one for right now. Springfield coming in, like I said, 8-7, 6-5, reaching 21. It's a big game for them, as it is for BCC. Mendez sinks both free throws.
What is it? BCC
trying to avenge their last loss on Tuesday. Can't afford to lose another regional game, and there's going to be a timeout on the floor, I think, by BCC. Yeah. All right. Yeah. So we'll keep it here. You're watching Bayhawks basketball here on Channel 95 in your dial. Here on the Bayhawks Broadcasted Network. It's Cardoza and Salvador on the call and Cabral. And we'll keep it here for a minute. Take a break. Go to the fridge. Grab a bud. Grab a beverage, sit back and relax.
Enjoy some basketball, you know. It's a nice day outside, enjoying some basketball. Big football game's coming up tomorrow.
Well, after you see this game, the result will probably be in. We'll probably know who's going to the Super Bowl. AFC Championship game tomorrow, 6:40.
Whether you're watching us on Channel 95, checking the games on YouTube. They get posted a couple days after they happen. So.
Lopez gets it inside to Hindley, and you're going to call steps. Must have moved that pivot foot. 31-24. Nonetheless, they call a travel on Isaiah Headley. Mendez at the point. Crossing over on Lopez. Ooh, Desire goes up and gets it. Gets it down inside to Baker. Can't get it.
Looks like Baker wanted a call but didn't get it.
Pushing the basketball. Lopez, how did he make that?
Wow.
Amongst the trees, Christopher Lopez with the lay-in. Back the other way. Mendez loses it. Tried to lay it in. Couldn't.
You talk about Lopez being undersized. He is so quick. He's able to do stuff like that.
Yeah, he's buzzing like a bee when he gets that ball. He's looking to go one direction. He's looking to go full speed in one direction. Not afraid. But what a lay-in on the other end by Christopher Lopez, number two, on the previous possession. There he is right there. I don't know how he laid that ball in. That was Isaiah Thomas-esque. Those baskets when you see Isaiah Thomas for the Boston Celtics, when you're like, how did he get in the lane and make that amongst seven-footers?
Exactly. See a guy that height do that.
Bissett scoops it up and under. Under Lope, under Desire. It's a three-point game. Desire coming up to set the pick. Ricardo scoops it up. Left hand drops it.
Yep. He's going to the line, getting the and one.
Ricardo not even showing the emotion. That was just like a day at the office for him as he drops the dime. Bayhawks have lost two games at home this year. They're actually 5-1 on the road. They're 4-2 at home. Mercado misses a free throw. Both teams have nine team fouls. It's going to stay white ball. It's going to stay Bristol ball.
Rams doing a good job matching the Bayhawks' speed. Both teams playing very aggressive and fast.
Oh, they're going to call a foul. I knew that was going to be a foul on Pope.
Yeah, it is.
McCarthy tried to dump it into him on the alley, but going over the back was Quincy Pope. And he's going to come out of the game, and now he has three. Here's Bissett handling the ball.
That was a nice pass
to Headley. Headley on the drive. Picks up his dribble, back out. Driving to his left, Bissett. Nice bounce pass in to Gordon. Makes it.
You know, BCC started this game scoring right out of the box. Now the Rams doing a great job coming back, matching them.
You got that right. Here's Baker, double team. McCarthy swings it to Mendez for three. It's got to be short.
No.
Rebounded by Headley. You're right, Craig. Springfield is owned like the last 10 minutes here at least.
They're calling travel on that.
Yeah, Gordon didn't know which way he was going. He got caught up. Move too quick. 33-30.
Give him credit because he's actually wearing glasses. Not even sports goggles, just regular glasses.
Brave. Oh, nice pass by Mendez. Gets it inside. Is that Baker?
That is Baker.
Ooh, wow, Bissett blowing by, no, was trying to blow by Mendez.
Nope.
And they're going to call steps there. Back-to-back travel calls. Now it's starting to get hot in here.
Hot in the sweat box.
In the sweat box. McCarthy doing a good job of using his body. Gets it inside to Baker. Can't make it home. Rebounded by Gordon with the glasses, as you said. Headley in the lane. No good. McCarthy with the ball. And they're going to call a foul on Headley. Headley's one of those players where he's not just a scorer. I mean, he has the ability to drive and score. We've seen that, but we've seen him not the point guard, but they give him the ball out there, and he has the ability to either shoot drive or pass. He's like one of those players.
He's built pretty big, so he's able to just run right through the opposing players.
But he's unselfish.
It's a great quality to have.
Like, you know, like Bissett and Bissett, Christopher Lopez, and R.J. Veneziano. Those guys are like the primary ball handlers, but it's almost like Headley's like a point forward as well. Like, they give it to him at the top of the key, and he's got the option to do whatever he wants to do.
Bayhawks with hard coverage.
Here's Bissett. Mendez all over him like a cheap suit. In the corner, number four, the jumper is good. Lorenzo Akins getting into the action. 5-point lead. Mercado tried to get inside.
What a
save.
Desire,
knocked away.
Did you see that catch as it was going away from him?
That was Gordon who knocked it away. The three. Bissett checks it. 1, 2, 3.
We got ourselves a 2-point game.
Cross court pass way over Mendez, and BCC looks tired.
And that's what we talked about earlier. They have that long passing game, and it doesn't always work for them.
Too many cross court passes.
With three left in the half, only a 2-point game, that can be big. And foul will be on Danny Mendez. And it's going to be the first foul of the day for the number one. Even 10 fouls on both sides.
Yeah, been a very physical basketball game. And it's going up and it's very pushy, very, very aggressive, very up and down.
Something we've seen from BCC, they're very intense, very aggressive, and now they're playing a team that's matching them in every step of the way.
They are. They're making BCC work for everything they get. Yeah. And we marveled at the deepness of BCC's bench, and they get a lot of guys that can shoot and score. And they were up on this team. They had a 15-point lead. Mendez going strong off the glass.
Yeah.
Right? Wasn't it 25-10 at one point?
It was.
Gonna do some fuzzy math, but since it was 25-10 earlier in the first half, it's been about a 27-12 run. Yeah, 27-12 run.
The Rams just been playing well. They've been making, they've been capitalizing on mistakes that BCC's been making, and they're just passing well. They're scoring well. They're driving well. They're covering really well. Both teams playing pretty good defense, which that's what's beating BCC. It's more or less their offense. They're making offensive mistakes, not necessarily defensive mistakes.
And BCC has gotten a little tight on offense. Their offense was going smoothly. It seems like they've gotten a little tight.
Both teams been playing tight. That's why we're seeing so many fouls. You know?
Here's Bissett. Bissett is like the Jamie Staples of this men's team. Like the floor general.
The men's team all around, though, playing better than the women's team.
Yes, that's for sure. Mercado going baseline. Gets it in Desire. And nice hands by Desire, who puts it up and in. Nice pass by Mercado driving baseline.
Kevin Desire, I feel like, needs to be a bigger presence right now for BCC.
Yeah, Kevin Desire brings a lot to the table. And they're going to call offensive. And that's big. BCC was almost in danger of losing this lead. A lot of basketball to play in this one. We're going to expect to...
Yep.
Going to expect this one to get right down to the nitty-gritty.
Can we get
an exciting second half.
Can we get the towel boy out? Wipe that up.
The towel boy?
Yeah.
Hey, towel boy.
I'm not doing double duty. I'm not acting as the towel boy either.
Towel boy.
Ooh, that was risky.
No, you're not a towel boy. You're just a cowboy. Cowboy. And Mercado misses it. Gets his own rebound. McCarthy flips it back to Mercado in the corner for three. Jose Mercado. Jose, can you three?
I like that. Oh, look at the handles.
Bissett leaning into Mendez off the rim. Gordon with the rebound over Desire.
Now I definitely see what you mean by Bissett seeming like Jamie Staples, those handles.
Costell Lou, he's not liking that.
No.
Desire getting outworked underneath there. Arvid Gordon got some size to him. Only a freshman forward for this team.
And through the power of glasses, he makes the first one.
I look at three players out there right now, and Jose Mercado. Well, actually, no, two. Kevin Desire and Jose Mercado weren't in the last game. But awfully, they're two vital cogs for this team.
Another risky pass.
Ah,
there's
Desire.
A big risk.
I mean, I'm sorry, Mendez with a poor pass there. But then he tries to make up for it.
No.
Good hustle. Mendez always hustling.
Yeah, it was just a combination of not the best pass, and also McCarthy was just caught napping. That got stolen away pretty easily.
Mendez got caught up in the middle, realized he wasn't going to have a good shot opportunity there, giving up a lot of height. Kind of got collapsed on. He tried to kick it out real quick, but it didn't have enough on it. But then at least on the other end, hustling to get that ball back.
Oh, what, this play just now?
Yeah.
I was talking about the one back there.
Oh, okay.
No, that one was just, he just got kind of taken out.
Yeah, he got taken out. All right, so we're keeping it here. 44-39, 5-point lead.
Less than a minute left in the half.
And we get ourselves a barn burner.
Is this the part where we get our Spygate tactics going?
Our Spygate tactics.
Yeah.
Put that camera over there in the Springfield so you get their signals.
See if you can get his clipboard.
All right, so as Coach Rod Del Lu instructs this team, 44-39, we'll look at the BCC men's basketball schedule going forward. Okay, they're at Roxbury next Thursday, January 26th, will be on the call. They'll play in Roxbury at 8 p.m. That's going to be following the girls' basketball game. Girls are playing in Roxbury. Roxbury girls are the number one team in the country. And the men's basketball team will face the Roxbury men at 8 p.m. Also, BCC will face Holyoke at 3 p.m. on January 28th. And then they'll round out the January schedule at Mass Bay at 7 p.m. So another home game for BCC on Thursday. And they round out the January schedule on the road against Holyoke and Mass Bay. Three road games for them in a row as they'll face UConn, the University of Connecticut at Avery Point, and on February 4th. Losing the basketball is Bissett, but right into Headley's hands. Seven on the shot clock. BCC playing good D. Headley going against Baker. Puts it up somehow off the glass. Rebounded by McCarthy. McCarthy pushing it for the Bayhawks. Out to Mercado. Thought about three. Gets it blocked. What a block by Gordon.
Wow.
Mercado gets it back. Back out to McCarthy.
No shot clock with 20 seconds left in the half.
No shot clock, as you said, Craig. 13 on the game clock.
Got 10 now. He's got to do
Setting
something.
Setting the pick is Desire. McCarthy back out to Mendez for three. No good.
Oh. Nope. Three left. It will be the Bayhawks ball, so there will be a chance for a shot at the buzzer.
Yeah, knocked away there. 3 seconds. 5-point lead for BCC.
Okay, here's what he does. He's got to throw it straight up in the air, clear all the bars, and make it in from back there. Ultimate trick shots right there.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Oh, nobody was guarding Desire.
Wow.
Nobody was knocking him out there. Gordon. Wonder what happened there as Desire was all alone. Nice pass there by McCarthy, and a good way for BCC to end the first half. So a tale of two halves and within one, because BCC played stellar. They played lights out getting up 15 points in the early going, but Springfield has done a great job to get back into it. So for Cardoza and Craig Salvador on the call, you're watching Bayhawks basketball. It's 46-39 at the half. Tune in for the second half here in a little bit. All right, I want to welcome back everybody to Bishop Colony High School, the home of the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. You're watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media, channel 95 on your dial. This is brought to you by FR Media and Bristol Community College, because Bristol.
Yep, you can also catch us on our official YouTube channel, youtube.com/Bristol Community College.
Yep, Bristol Community College, changing the world, learner by learner. All right, we're all set for second half action. This one looking to be a barn burner. 46-39, Bayhawks have the lead. McCarthy out the break. Misses the first one, so we're just getting underway here in the second half. It's Cardoza and Craig Salvador. David Cardoza, Craig Salvador on the call. And Lucy Cabral with the fancy camera work.
There's a nice souvenir for a fan in the crowd.
A little bit of a lively atmosphere here on a Saturday afternoon.
Well, it comes from a lot of the energy from the benches.
Okay. Wow, what a save there by Pierre. And he gets it to go on the other end.
Please. Oh.
Collision. And this doesn't look good.
No.
Right now.
Now Jernigan's down. Might have hit his head.
Jernigan. And Headley's a hefty player. Jernigan holding his ribs now, too. A little shaken up on the play. Hopefully he's okay. He's holding his ribs right now. That's never a good thing. Headley's up, so both players up. Probably shake it off and go amongst their business. But Desmond Jernigan going to stay in the game. He will, and he's going to inbound the basketball.
I want to talk about it. I hope we got that save on camera, because that's SportsCenter worthy. It's the amazing backward save.
Yeah, it was an awesome
McCarthy
save.
And for the fact that he was able to lay it in.
And Jernigan's going to get fouled. Looks like it's going to be on Headley. All right, some first half stats. Jose Mercado actually led the Bayhawks with 13. Marcus McCarthy had 9. And your boy Quincy Pope also had 9 as well. Other players chipping in was Danny Mendez.
So despite the soreness, Jernigan lays in the first one.
Danny Mendez and Ronnie Baker. Just and just like that, BCC's up 10. Springfield closed the gap to as much as two at one point, made it 37-35. BCC's opened it up a little bit since then.
Yeah, but we've seen Springfield come back this game before.
Goodness gracious. Wow.
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 Jeez, you're talking about Megan Parrish, Jamie Staples at WrestleMania. Look at this.
Wow. What the heck was that? It was like an arm drag.
Yeah.
It's a classic arm drag.
Looks like you tried to roll him up. Try to roll him up, get the three count.
Is that McCarthy? That was those two words.
That was McCarthy and somebody.
Marty, yeah.
Went like around the world on him, threw him down.
RJ Veneziano got tossed to the ground there. And who's the foul called on?
It's off McCarthy. Looks like a football play right there.
We've seen two collisions. We've seen a couple collisions here in the last 30 seconds here. Things are getting kind of nuts. Where they're calling a flagrant foul, and I believe it's going to be on McCarthy.
Yeah, it is McCarthy, and it's going to be on red number
McCarthy,
three.
Obviously.
That is.
McCarthy had the arm drag.
Yep.
So Veneziano will go to the line to shoot the technical. Another technical for BCC. They've got a couple on this game.
Only thing missing, one of us yelling, Stone Cold! Stone Cold! Stone Cold!
The glass breaks. Isaiah Heady had 9 points in the first half for Springfield Tech. And also Arvin Gordon leads all scorers with 14.
Yeah, we're only a minute into this half and a lot of craziness already.
A lot of craziness. Inbound to the basketball, Springfield. As we're just getting underway. Here's Gordon being guarded by Jernigan. Here's Bissett. Gets it underneath and scoring it. Victor Agde. That technical foul might have sparked the Rams. Dump it inside of Jernigan. Back out to Baker. That Springfield defense coming alive. That's Ricardo from the corner. Can't drop it. Rebounded by Baker. Up. Loose ball. Going this way. Victor Agde with a slam.
Wow.
Slamming it on Ricardo. Bring it down the house. And the Rams bench loves it. And I think he got the foul as well. Mercado fouled him. Jose Mercado getting posterized there by Victor Agde.
Hey, you talk about keeping the pace up. They're taking the pace by the jersey, throwing it over his face, and then just beating the pace down. This is intense.
Yeah, this is very intense. And the technical foul, I believe they're going to call that on Springfield, maybe the excessive celebration there or something, because I'm not exactly sure what the...
Well, either way, it's McCarthy at the line. McCarthy's a very good shooter.
We've seen three technical fouls total for each team. Yeah, McCarthy sinks both free throws. And BCC will keep the basketball, so. Not a smart technical foul there by Springfield as they were trying to climb back into this one. They're right there, though, 51-44.
They've got
a lot of time left here.
They've come back from a bigger deficit in this game. You know, like we talked about, one point BCC had 15 points over them. Rams came right back to tie it.
Yeah, the Rams, they're energized. They came here to play.
That's a foul on Mercado. Oh, no, it's not, actually.
They didn't travel 3 hours for nothing. All right, BCC, Rob DelLue, Coach Rob DelLue going to call a timeout. 17:46 left to play. 51-41. Bayhawks got the lead. We'll keep it right here. All right, ladies and gentlemen, you like sports talk radio? You like Boston sports? Listen to the Dirty Water Sports Hour on Thursday afternoons at 4 p.m. with Cardoza, that's me, and Andrews.
That isn't me.
That's Thirsty Thursdays. Thirsty Thursdays come alive. Bringing it to you on bccradio.org. Also, if you haven't listened to the show yet, you want to check it out, go to archive.org, put in the little search engine, the Dirty Water Sports Hour, and you can see all of our latest shows. From this year and last year. Check it out. Also on Bristol Community College Radio, bccradio.org on Friday mornings at 10 a.m. You can listen to the I Love Lucy show with our own Lucy Cabral doing the fancy camera work. That show's at 10 a.m. with a variety of music and talk about all the latest that's going down in the world. Drive it to the lane, Marcus McCarthy. Drops it in, 53-44. Things are starting to get crazy in the old mill city of the river, Fall River. Here's Veziano. Veziano drives to his left. Ooh. It somehow gets inside. That shot's going to be missed by Lorenzo Akins. Going back the other way furiously is Mercado. Drops it in to Jernigan. Nice take by Mercado. Showing the unselfishness as he drops it.
It's a great run. That's a great run by Mercado, coming in with a full head of steam, knowing exactly what he's going to do.
He's so fast.
It's the man bun.
It's the man. Gordon's going to be traveled. Seen that coming.
Great job by the Bayhawks forcing the mistake.
It seems like every time Springfield makes a charge, it seems like BCC kind of bounces right back and reasserts themselves, and Springfield can't get any closer. It's an 11-point lead. McCarthy, nice. Jernigan at the free throw line, no good. Wow, look at the ups by Veziano on that one.
He just better hopes he doesn't get arm dragged again by McCarthy.
Hands off to Bissett. Kicks it back out to Veneziano. No fear. Gets it inside to Gordon. Nice drop off. Lays it in. Gordon, the leading scorer of the game. On both sides. Mercado's built like a you-know-what house. Good solid build to him.
Looks like they're having problems with the clock.
As they usually do.
Yeah, trying to adjust the time.
At Conley.
Now there's only 1 second left in the game. And it's back.
Watch it right here. I wish we had the replay. McCarthy, nice pass inside to Baker. Gets fouled. I believe they're going to call it on Gordon. They do.
Yep.
Good job to pound it into Armani Baker. Gordon's got his third foul. They can't afford him to go out. He's been their best overall player. And their leading scorer. Baker sinks the first free throw. 56-46. And five team fouls already by the guest Rams. Baker sinks both free throws. Back to an 11-point lead. BCC picking up man.
Yeah, BCC out of the gate doing a better job on not drawing as many fouls.
That's for sure.
And just as I say that, I think this happened last game too. Second, I said that they were doing better at not drawing fouls, they just drew one.
And then they drew a bunch late. Veneziano drives the lane, gets it inside to Gordon. Had it knocked away by Baker, but while he's doing that, he commits the foul. It is going to be on Baker.
Yep.
And it looks like it's going to be his third.
A lot of players with three this game.
Got his. Sorry, that's the second. Underneath to Gordon. And they're going to call a foul. And they're going to call it on Jernigan again.
Yeah,
number
four. Jernigan does not like that call. Kevin Desire is going to be coming in. And probably going to be coming in for Jernigan. He's in foul trouble.
Thinking that free throw is Gordon. Coming into the basketball game for BCC is going to be Kevin Desire.
Haven't seen a whole lot of Kevin Desire this game.
Yeah, he wasn't in the starting lineup. He kind of came off the bench for a little bit in the first half. But like you said, yeah, not too much of him. Desire setting the pick. Here's Pope. Gets it to Baker, where he likes it. In the sweet spot. He steps out of bounds. Yeah. It's so funny because Baker loves the ball right there, and he's so good about he's so precise and so good about, you know, driving that baseline. This time he steps out of bounds.
Yeah, Springfield Tech with better coverage than T-Mobile right now. Forcing mistakes, really.
Yeah, Springfield's doing a good job of that. Oh, nice head fake.
Fouling on our money, Baker.
Another foul. Yeah, they had him. You know, Baker and Headley, that's a good matchup right there. Both kind of the same height. Both kind of play the same way. Bissett back out to Headley. Headley for three. Gets it. Wow. Headley showing all facets of his game. Cuts it to six. Cross-court pass to Pope. Mendez swings it. Pope gets it back.
They're just passing everywhere
right now. That zone is moving by Springfield. In the lane. Oh, knocked away by Gordon. They're going to call a foul on him, and that's going to be tough, man. That's his fourth. I believe that's going to be Arvin Gordon's fourth foul. It is. And someone's going to need to come in for him. There's a lot of time left in this game.
Yep. See Jose Mercado getting set to come in.
And Quincy Pope misses the first free throw. Jose Mercado comes in for Baker, who's in a little bit of foul trouble. Baker having a tough game today. That free throw drops in. Haven't seen too much of the press. Usually BCC likes to press. They usually pick up that man-to-man press, or they got that trap going. Not today. Drive it to his left. Spinning in the lane is Headley. Off the glass and in. Boy, is he doing it.
These are two teams that really match in style. Very similar style and play. They're matching each other point for point right now.
He could do it all. Oh, nice drive there by McCarthy.
Oh.
The lay-in is no good. Mendez somehow gets the rebound in there. The little guy, number one.
He tried to go up for it, but he ended up running into a wall.
Yeah, brick wall. Well, the foul's on number four. He's not exactly a brick wall as Lorenzo Akins.
No, but there was like three guys
on
him.
Well, it was like a wall, yeah. The whole
team.
When you put them all together. Mendez sinks it. A lot of time left in this one. Mendez sinks both. 60-53. Knocked out of bounds by McCarthy.
The fan has no hands.
The fan has no hands.
Yeah, he should have caught that.
Give him a break, you savage.
Nah, he should have caught it.
All right. Gordon, jumper, no good. I'm surprised he's still in the game with four. Arvin Gordon's still in the game.
Exactly, especially with how close of a game this is. You're definitely going to need him for later.
Yeah. And the time. Defense! 13 on the shot clock. Pope. Mendez swings it in the corner to McCarthy for three. Bangs it home. McCarthy.
So that was a great pass by Pope and then a nice swing by Mendez to get it.
Coach Delalue looking like he's going to hemorrhage over there. Goodness gracious.
Well, that's a scramble for everything.
Oselu looking to blow a gasket over there. 63-53. But you can feel the intensity.
Oh, nice coverage. This one's going to stay down.
Loose ball, and they're going to call a foul on Quincy Pope.
Uh,
Quincy Pope had a lot of questionable calls.
It has not been a good day for the Pope.
No. A couple of them have been questionable, you know.
They're arguing he was nowhere near the play on that
one. Well, not on that one, but it seemed like there's been like three separate occasions where he's had his hands out like, what did I do? That one was kind of questionable. That's four on Quincy Pope. And
Rob Del Luz trying to question it.
I think you get the wrong guy.
That's what they're arguing. I think they're trying to call it. I think they're saying the foul was on Kevin Desire, but Pope got the – Pope's the one with his hand caught in the cookie jar. Still so many guys in foul trouble now.
Here's Dan Mendes. Over to McCarthy. Swings it in the corner. Ricardo for three. Gets it. Jose, can you three?
Beautiful loft. Beautiful release for the three-pointer.
Oh.
Big travel.
And that was a brain fart right there by Bissett.
Yes. Yeah, just like you said, brain cramp. Didn't know what to do.
I'm not sure what he was doing. There was nobody around him. There's no one to intimidate. I don't know what was going on there. But anyways.
I don't know. Looked like he thought he had someone behind him, but no. He just added the corp to himself.
He heard the footsteps. The ghost of Bishop Conley are out here. The ghost of Bishop Conley High School. So 66-55. You're watching Bayhawks basketball here in the Dirty River. 12:42 left to play here. And there's a lot to play for. This is a regional game. Bristol looking for their 10th win. Springfield looking for their 9th. So this is a time of year where postseason positioning starts to get in motion. You want to be playing your best basketball. Last year, the Bayhawks went on 11. They rode an 11-game win streak last season, going all the way into the postseason.
It's definitely been an interesting game to see the main squad back. You know, like we said, last game was completely a different team. Now we got a lot of core guys now. So definitely interesting game seeing them all back.
The main squad is back, and you can see the firepower. You can see the potential. But for some reason, it looks like they're still trying to gel today, getting each other back, getting everybody back, you know?
Yeah. Exactly. They're playing a team that, despite it's an 11-point lead, but still, this team is very capable of coming right back at it.
And you said it. But Arvin Gordon, they can't afford him to come out.
Nope.
They can't afford for him to get fouled out of this game. Number 20, he's got 14 fouls. So both teams are in foul trouble. Both teams are now in the bonus with a lot of time left to play here.
Yeah, by the end of this might just be a battle of the benches.
Battle of the benches. Well, at least both teams have enough players where if they lose a few guys, they're not going to be power playing it.
Yeah.
5-on-3, 5-on-4, something like that.
Get to see guys we haven't seen play yet, like Mason Turner.
Hey, I'll get out there and suit up.
Luis Rosario, see some guys we haven't seen yet.
I'll start throwing elbows.
Dave Cardoza come out of retirement to destroy.
I could go out there and play, but I get myself about three times up the floor before I get gassed. I'll be dead. And they're going to call it travel. They're going to call it on Lopez. Lopez had his hands up, but you travel, buddy.
Was it a couple years ago? Didn't Charles Barkley race a referee or something? Someone raced a referee not too long ago. It was like a really, really old ref and like some out-of-shape old NBA
he
player.
He raced him?
Mercado. Yeah, they raced down the court. I forget who it was. I'm pretty sure it was Charles Barkley.
Who won?
I think Barkley. I think the ref tripped. Or was the other way around? I don't remember.
Didn't see that one. Going down the block is Headley. Got three BCC players around him. Desire takes it away. And I think they're going to call a foul on Desire.
Yep. And they call this one on Kevin Desire, not Quincy Pope this time. Only Desire's second foul.
That looked like a clean takeaway. I'm not sure what that was all about.
We saw Desire kind of shocked he got the call on him.
I think Coach Delu was kind of shocked too. Headley makes free throw. Both teams have 18 fouls. The Rams and the Bayhawks both with 18 fouls. So they'll both be shooting 1-1 going forward. Both free throws made. Back to an 11-point lead. It seems like it's always an 11-point lead. And Arvin Gordon finally gets out of the game. He's going to need a rest. They need to save him for crunch time. For the Rams, for their sake, they hope they can stay in this game long enough. They get inside to Desire, loses it, and they're going to call a jump, and they're going to call a possession arrow in favor of the Rams.
Rams getting a lot of calls this half.
Yes, sir. Here's Headley, getting into the paint. Jumper, no good. Gets his own rebound. Up and under, off the glass, no good. Nice move by Headley.
I tell you, I'm surprised he came down with that. He went through four guys to bring out his own rebound.
Yeah, that was unbelievable. And the head fake, the up and under, the ability to get up and under and even have a chance at that. That was a marvelous move by Isaiah Headley. Nine on the shot clock. BCC in zone. In the corner is Headley. Bangs it home. Boy, has he been putting on a show here in the second half.
Yeah, Coach Rob Delu clearly frustrated with that.
Very frustrated.
Yeah, this is only an 8-point game now.
McCarthy to Mercado. And they're going to call a foul on the little fella. Number two, Christopher Lopez. Number two. Two for number two.
Yep.
And Jose Mercado's going to go to the line, shooting the front end of a 1-1. And next, the Portuguese Cowboy is going to be out there during our next break singing the Bayhawks fight song.
Oh, yeah. So hear my sexy voice doing that.
What is the Bayhawks fight song?
I don't know.
Dead or alive.
I thought that was my theme song.
That's your theme song.
Well,
on the other end, Desire with the rebound.
Yeah, Desire with a look what I found kind of play.
Driving the lane is McCarthy. It drops the floater in.
Making it look easy is McCarthy.
BCC pick it up, man. BCC can wear you down. Lopez somehow puts it up. Rebound by Mercado. Oh, Desire. He had Desire. Oh, working his way, weaving his way in. And they're going to call travel.
Ooh.
It did look like he took too many steps.
Yeah.
Like traveled we said, all the way to the grocery store with that one.
Like we said, it looked like he wanted to pass to Desire, but just didn't have the open shot.
Yeah, well, Kevin didn't make himself available until late. It seemed like he stopped, like he let up.
He might have thought Mercado had it all the way going for a layup.
Well, once you're a basketball player, sometimes you get one thing in your head that has Headley. No good. Gets his own rebound. Gonna block him out.
Gets it back.
Gets it back off the glass and in. Very workmanlike. Headley keeping the Rams in it. In it to win it. And now they're going to check Gordon back in.
That was a big play right there, just stealing it away, getting it himself, doing it all himself.
McCarthy underneath to Baker, and the foul is good.
So on the red 10, Armani Baker with the and one.
The fashion plate Armani. Baker's got good hands. Way to go to catch that pass, put above the glass simultaneously.
That's what we see. Marty Baker, he always seems to be getting double-doubles. We saw that earlier in the season. And he completes the old-fashioned three-point play. Baker's really cooking.
It's like a good slot receiver. 75-62. And they're going to call steps.
It looked like he was tripping over his own feet. Couldn't really recover.
Well, sometimes BCC with their defense and the way they put pressure on you from the beginning tap all the way to the end, sometimes they force you to do very dumb things. And that's what they're finding out. This is the biggest lead I think they've had since it was 25-10 earlier on. It's been around 10. It's been around 11. It's a 13-point lead, 9:17 left to play for BCC. So what have you seen this far? What are the changes you've seen in the Bayhawks? Because they ended the first half on a really, not so good note, to put it very lightly.
I think the defense has been better for the Bayhawks. Their offense has still been there from the first half, but their defense has been a lot better now, and they're forcing the Rams to make bigger mistakes because that's what the Rams were capitalizing before was they were just getting good passing going, and now whenever they're passing, BCC is just having such good coverage they can just steal it away. Force the Rams to throw out of bounds.
Yeah,
just
like
take bad shots.
It seems like BCC's defensive presence is more energized right now. We got another wet spot.
Yep, towel boy's coming.
It's like that old parquet floor of the Boston Garden. It's always sweaty here in the sweatshop. Down at the sweatshop. We'll be having some fun at the sweatshop.
Dave Cardoza, everybody.
I'll be singing the national anthem next home game. Sorry, Lucy.
Does that mean Lucy?
Jump it in. Baker. That's another thing. Baker likes to get the ball at the top of the key or at the free throw line and kind of drive from there. Baker's going to go to the line. That's going to be the 10th team foul. The 10th team foul on the Rams, and BCC will be shooting two free throws going forward with a lot of time left in this one. And BCC has a chance to extend their lead.
Yeah, this is something we've seen all game from both sides, really. This is where a lot of the points come from are from foul shots. And this half, definitely, BCC is taking advantage of that.
It's too early. Right now it's too early to to be shooting free throws so early. Too early to be in the bonus, but both teams are in the bonus now, so it's going to slow the game down. Baker misses his first free throw. One player who didn't suit up today, not sure if it's injury-related, is Devontae Holloway down there. Both free throws missed.
They're calling an immediate foul on Kevin Desire.
And that's going to mean there's going to be free throws going back the other way. Ninth team foul. One more team foul for BCC, and both teams are going to be in the double bonus, meaning every foul from here on out is going to be two shots taken by each team.
And this could be the problem with how frequent now foul shots are going to be. You could have guys who are just hot out of the gate, and this gives them that time to cool down, and they might not be able to adjust back.
Certainly.
Then the other flip side, you got the guys who might be gassed. This gives them time to get their energy back.
Well, that's true.
So it can really go either way. Get the guys who are hot to start slowing down. Get the guys who are slowing down to get hot again.
Gives them a chance to catch their breath. This is the first we've seen of Anthony Gaudy Jimenez. He just made both of those free throws. It's back to an 11-point lead. Arvin Gordon won the lead. One of the leading scorers for Springfield is back in. Mendes getting in the lane. Drops it down to Baker. No good. Put back. No good. Tipped up. Rebounded by the Rams. That's Bissett. Hadley for three. Up. No good. Yeah. Almost got the roll. I tell you what, Isaiah Hadley has really been... He's really kept this team in it.
Yeah, I haven't seen him miss a lot of three-pointers, but he did that time.
had the open look, and he's got the touch. That one kind of just rolled out, but Baker's going to go to the line.
Yeah.
Baker's very inconsistent from the line. Makes that free throw.
Hey, you don't really see him as a shooter. He's the guy who comes in, gets the rebound, puts it back up.
He's a guy that does his damage, obviously, around the basket or from, like, 15 feet and in.
Yeah. Which is good because we got a lot of guys on the team who are able to shoot for distance.
And as I say that, Baker makes both free throws. Bissett kicks it back out. Anthony Gowdy Jimenez makes it. Wow. Where's he coming from? 5 points.
Big plays coming off the bench.
Yeah. Quick 5 points for him.
And brings the lead back to the magic number 11.
This one's still not over. Jernigan from the elbow. Jumper is good. Desmond for the deuce.
That's a beautiful mid-range shot for two.
Bissett.
Oh.
Ooh, Bissett lost control of it. And they're going to call a foul. I don't know how they call that.
I don't know either. It just looked like he slipped. Foul's going to be on Danny Mendez. Yeah, and I'm surprised they called the foul on that. It just looked like he just simply slipped over his own momentum.
Simply slipped. I don't know what they're calling.
They're calling something either way. And yeah, now really is called the sweat box.
A lot of slippery slopes
out there. You can see the shine on the court.
Yeah. Slimy sweat. First free throw is good by Bissett.
I mean, both teams playing as hard as they can. You know, not surprised how much sweat there is.
Yeah, definitely a lot of effort out there today for sure.
We've seen the Bayhawks. They usually go all of their games. They go hard, play really aggressive, and this is one of the first times we've seen a team really match them right now.
Yeah, Springfield definitely matching the intensity. But you weren't here Tuesday when Bunker Hill was here. Bunker Hill, it was like a home game for them. I mean, they dominated in every facet of the game, and their fans were boisterous too. Here's Mercado, and they're going to call travel. Another travel call on Mercado. Happened to him a few times in this game.
Yeah. Danny Mendez made the practice three, though.
Man.
Yeah, this is getting dangerous now.
Gonna have to put a carpet out there. Put some cement out there.
Hope they got their non-slip shoes on.
Headley. Guarded by Mercado. Try to double team. Bissett going in, leads it in and off the glass. Nice move by Bissett.
Yeah, Bissett went flying on that one.
Mendez in the corner. Mercado where he likes it. No good. No bueno. 79-70. Springfield just can't get close enough. They're hanging around. Actually, Isaiah Headley, he can make this a 7-point game if he makes both free throws here. That's four, and also that's four fouls on Armani Baker. Excuse me.
Both teams right now are more or less evenly matched. The Bayhawks were just able to get that quick run to get ahead, and now they're just both playing pretty much equal basketball, trading points left and right. But the Bayhawks, they just have that cushion. They have that privilege of having that little bit of a lead that they're just able to hang on to. Both teams playing very equal now.
You're right. They came out gangbusters, and BCC came out with the intensity and played very well for the first part of the first half, and both teams have kind of been very even. You're exactly right, Mr. Cowboy.
Bang, bang.
Driving to his left. McCarthy stops. Cross to Mercado. 8 on the shot clock. McCarthy on the wing. Crossover. Forces up a three. Way off the glass as the shot clock near an end.
Yeah, he needed to get one off, and that was his best bet.
Oh, boy. Oh, what a move. Up and under around Desire. goodness gracious.
That would have been pretty.
Pretty spectacular. Headley, he just doesn't look like he has it in him when it comes to that kind of stuff, but boy.
Yeah, sneaky good athlete.
McCarthy gets it inside to Jernigan, gets it, rolls it in. Nice pass by McCarthy to a cutting Jernigan to lay it in, Craig.
And that's going to be the fifth foul on Gordon.
And they're going to call that foul on Gordon?
Yep, he's going to have to come off.
But that's the fifth. He's out of the game.
Yep.
Arvin Gordon.
That is a big hit for Springfield.
Arvin Gordon, the leading scorer at the half for both teams. Tough second half with foul trouble and kind of slow down there in the second half. And they're going to have to do it without him. That kind of hurts the Rams. Rams down 9 here. And Jernigan trying to complete the three-point play. Side rims it. Here's Bissett being guarded closely by Danny Mendez. Mendez being a pest. Ooh, going baseline, puts it up, no good. Victor Acti gets the foul. And now different guys are going to have to step up for the Rams if they want to win this game.
Fouls on Desmond Jernigan. This looks like it's going to be his fifth.
That's going to be his fifth. He's going to have to come out.
And Kevin Desire.
He fouls out, and Desire is going to go in.
That's also a big hit for the Bayhawks. Jernigan being out, that's going to be a big hit.
Yeah, because with Kevin Desire, I mean, you don't really have a guy that can score. With Desmond Jernigan, he's a guy that's got some scoring punch.
Kevin Desire has really been kept silent in this game. You know, you expect a bigger impact from him.
Ooh. Desire good enough for the rebound.
I don't know what that was about.
I think it was only the first free throw.
Yeah, it was.
And there's a two. I don't know what they were thinking. So that goes for naught. Both guys were going for the ball, too, which is kind of funny. And the second free throw was good. 8-point lead. Still a close one. Under 6 minutes to play now. ...14 on the shot clock.
Quincy Pope with the ball. Haven't seen him in a while.
Yeah. They forced Pope to pick up his dribble. Good defense by the Rams. McCarthy in the corner. Going to have to put it up. They did the ball go out of bounds?
Something happened. They're saying it's still the Bayhawks ball. Shot clock ran out.
There might be a second.
There's like 7 different calls going on the court right now.
Right now there's 0 time left on the shot clock.
Well, they called it down here to stay the Bayhawks ball. There was still a couple seconds left on the shot clock, so the Bayhawks probably going to get an inbounds with still like 2 seconds left on the shot clock.
I don't think it's going to be enough time. I get the Rams. I give Springfield Tech all the credit in the world. They're playing some good defense. They're forcing BCC to really earn it.
Yeah, they're going to have 1 second on the shot clock.
BCC having a tough time when they're in their half-court sets. 1 second left on the shot clock. Mercado, going to have to be an alley-oop to Baker.
Nope. Baker goes down.
And Headley.
It's a foul on Headley. 2 shots.
And if that's the foul on Headley.
Looks like he's going to be out of the game.
He's out of the game.
Oh, my, what a turn of events this game is going.
And, man, boy, is that a blow. The Rams losing their top 2 scorers, their top 2 players, their top 2 offensive threats. And that's huge. Who do you go to now?
It's like
you
number
can't
three.
Foul in that situation. 1 second left on the shot clock. I mean.
Yeah, no, that seemed like it was as good as done for a turnover.
Yeah, you don't have to do too much. Just you don't have to foul. Baker misses the free throw. Baker looked like he was going over the back there, but Headley undercutted him. And Baker makes a second free throw on this one.
You know, back to a 9-point lead do the Bayhawks have.
The set for three. Rolls out. Rebounded by McCarthy. And I think BCC is going to take over and put this game away.
They got 5 minutes left. They're definitely in Springfield's head now that Springfield's two best players are on the bench.
Yeah. Here's McCarthy with the elbow. Short jumper. Rolls out. Rebounded by Kevin Thompson now. Oh, stolen away by Mendez. Mendez slips it to McCarthy. Up and under. Going to get fouled. And they'll call a foul on number five, Kevin Thompson, the freshman forward.
That was a great steal by Danny Mendez coming out of nowhere, flying to steal it.
Mendez is always hustling. You're right. I mean, that was a nice play for him to get back in the picture. Cause a turnover. Whew. It's hot in here. First free throw. If BCC could make their free throws, this would be a much bigger lead.
Well, that one went out and in, or in and out.
Yeah, so that means almost.
Yeah, almost.
Only in horseshoes and hand grenades, my friend. Second free throw. 10-point lead. Double figures. Crossing over, Bissett. And another foul.
On a push. Danny Mendez gets the foul. That's his fourth.
He's got four. Four and a half to play from Conley, home of Bristol Community College. First free throw made by Bissett. Okay, he could cut it to eight.
Yeah, like I said before, both teams really just playing equal. Just Bayhawks had that quick advantage.
Yeah. Every time Springfield tried to creep close, you know.
You were talking about foul shots. Here's the thing. Springfield, they're not really taking advantage of it either. These are easy points they should be getting.
Nobody's taking advantage of it. Oh, this is slowing the game down.
Yeah.
And Springfield always forced at BCC late in the shot clock.
Yeah, it's down eight seconds.
Mercado loses the ball, gains it back, puts it up, no good. And stays with it. Was that Baker?
Man, talk
Baker
about
with the putback.
Talk about luck. That was pretty amazing.
Yeah, it was. I tell you what, BCC in the half court, they look lost right now. I think of BCC as a team that does well in transition when you kind of lock them down.
They're calling
the foul.
So they
have to get into a half-court offense. They seem to, you know, they're kind of inconsistent.
Yep. And meanwhile, that's happened. Quincy Pope is now just fouled out.
And here we go. So BCC starting to lose key guys.
Kevin Desire will be checking in for him. Pope, we saw big early on in the first half. It just kind of went quiet since then. And he disappeared for a little while because he was in foul trouble.
Yeah, he had a quick flurry. And he's had a tough game with the fouls.
Yeah, he's had a lot of foul calls not go his way. A lot of ones that seemingly either not on him or just not close, and he gets called for them.
Yeah, a lot of phantom foul calls.
Yeah.
That free throw, Jane, by Victor Akti. Akti.
The man with the hard-to-pronounce last name.
Yeah, Akti.
Victor A.
Springfield bench into the game. Chance of defense.
You got 3:30 left.
And man, that zone by Springfield. BCC having a hard time to figure it out. Mendez driving, turning around, fadeaway. It's good. Nice big fadeaway by the little guy, number one.
It was great movement as Springfield trying to go out of the gate.
Bissett, jumper no good, rebounded by Desire. And now time is going to be a factor for the Rams with 3 minutes to play.
The Bayhawks now slowing the pace down, realizing the time.
And that's what they're doing. They're slowing the game down. They're running the time off the clock.
Springfield not really doing anything about it, just keeping coverage.
Oh, McCarthy, delayed all around. He kind of lulled the Springfield defense to sleep, and then he drives it to the hole. Nice play by McCarthy.
That was a great break for them.
Crossing over. Akhti off the glass. Ooh. Wheels it home.
This does kind of go to show what happens when Springfield loses their two best players, two leading players this game at least.
Yeah, that kind of sealed the deal. Kind of sealed their fate, so to speak.
Yeah. We're at the point where even if we're starting to lose players, they got their two best on the bench, so it kind of evens out at this point, and we're still got that lead.
Nice bounce pass by McCarthy and the jam. Ooh. Baker!
Dude, Baker getting everyone excited.
Bissett.
Mendez gets the foul. He's claiming Bissett just slipped. We've seen this a couple times this game. Bissett's like slipping on ice.
And Danny Mendez doesn't like to call, but he's going to foul out of this game. That's five, it looks like.
Yeah. Well, it looks like Mendez didn't really touch him. He's just claiming Bissett just slipped.
Bissett keeps slipping, and he...
Yeah. We've seen bodies go flying all around this game. You know, from
Jose Espinal in the game. Bissett misses the first free throw, so BCC has pulled away just a little bit.
Yeah, they got a 14-point lead at the moment.
Yeah, Springfield was hanging around. We got a little bit of a crowd here. We got some youth players in here. 91-78.
Yeah, the youth players coming
Here's
in.
McCarthy. This is the biggest crowd we've had all year now.
Yep. Hey, the youth players should take note, show how to play with grit.
Oh, pass.
Just as I say, they should take note, they throw it away.
3-point shot. Oh, boy. Anthony Gaudi Jimenez, the guy with the big name, with the big shot, cuts it to 10. But again, only a minute 18 left to play.
Could be a little bit too late. We've seen Jimenez make big plays like that throughout this game, but he's not getting a lot of opportunity.
Well, he's only been in the game for a few minutes. Enough for a cup of coffee, so.
Exactly, but he's been big these few minutes. He's made a couple big threes like that, a few foul shots. Just hasn't been playing that much.
He's done well. I'm not sure why he hasn't got more playing time, but nonetheless, 91-81 BCC with the lead. Looking to go 10-3 overall, 10-3 in the conference as well. And BCC looking for their ninth win in their last 10 games. The one blip coming against Bunker Hill this past Tuesday. 91-81, minute 18 to play. It's been a great Saturday of basketball in the first game, if you missed it. If you didn't watch the BCC women's team. They came out victorious against Springfield Technical Community College. And the Bayhawks, the men's team, looking to make it a clean sweep over Springfield and kind of send them on their way to a long, lonely drive back to Springfield. You ever go to Springfield?
Wow. I don't think I ever have.
It's the worst town in Massachusetts.
Oh, now you're just adding insult to injury. we're beating them. Now you're talking smack about their town.
No, well, I went there last year for the region tournament. And I stood up there, and I was looking for something to do, and it's just like the most ghettoest town. I'm sorry. It is. There's not much there. You think of Springfield, home of the Basketball Hall of Fame, home of Homer Simpson.
I don't think it's that Springfield, though.
Oh, man. But, yeah, I wasn't impressed. I went to this little dive bar. Yeah, it's a story for another day.
Is that the story for the Dirty Water Sports Radio Show?
Yeah, the Dirty Water Sports Hour. The Dirty Water Sports Hour.
It's less than a minute left. It looks like this game's kind of sealed.
I was told to stay away from downtown Springfield. That's what I was told.
Is it no bueno?
Yeah. Both free throws made, or one free throw made by McCarthy.
Yeah, 50 seconds left. 11-point lead. Kind of looks like this could be it.
Three-pointer by Ekdi. No good. Baker high for the rebound.
Yep, Carthy low and slow.
Give the fans what they want. Give the kids what they want. Get them a dunk. Let's see an alley-oop.
Wouldn't that
Why can't
really
Ryan Stopka get in this game?
He doesn't even have his jersey on. Well, he probably has it under, but he's still got his practice shirt on.
Well, yeah. This is usually Stopka time.
Yeah, every time should be Stopka time.
Yeah.
Give him what
Let
they
him
want.
Slam it. Oh, he was going for it.
You know he wanted it.
He was going for it, man. 94 to 81.
Either way, this is going to be over, but might as well send the fans home happy.
Jimenez misses his first shot, I think. And that's going to be it. Mercado gets the rebound.
Did you see that guy right there?
And that's going to be it. The final score from Bishop Connolly High School in Fall River, Massachusetts, 94 to 81. The men's Bristol Community College Bayhawks team takes a victory. As the two show some sportsmanship, two teams show some sportsmanship right here with some handshakes. Coach Rob Del Lue with another big victory. Bristol Community College goes to 10-3, 10-3 in region 21. Springfield Tech drops to 8-8, 6-6 in region 21. So, Our Bayhawks player of the game is going to go to, what do you think?
I don't know. It could go to a lot of people.
It could go to a lot of people.
Who do you think it should go to?
Well, let's give it to your boy Quincy Pope, because I thought he was very big at the beginning of this game. Anyway, so Bristol Community College walks out here a winner. They finish. They are now 10-3. The next game, you can watch the Bristol Community College Bayhawks. It's on Thursday when they face Roxbury as part of a doubleheader. So for Cardoza, Cowboy Craig, and Cabral, you've been watching Bayhawks basketball here on FR Media. The Bayhawks are winners, 94 to 81 over Springfield Tech. Good night, everybody.
Catch you later.